Hey guys, it's Ash, and today I'll be sharing my Hog Rider with the Prince combo deck. If you're a fan of heavy offense, fast-paced decks, then you're gonna love this deck. I'm not sure why the Hog Prince combo isn't as common as many of the other Hog cycle decks, but it definitely puts a lot of pressure on your opponent. We have a very low average elixir cost of 3.0, allowing you to cycle back your Hog Rider and Prince very quickly. And both of these cards put a lot of pressure on your opponent because they're not only fast, but can also be combined with other low elixir cards to form powerful combos. And what I love the most about the Hog Rider Prince combo is that you can attack your opponent on both lanes. For example, say you went with the Hog Rider Skeleton combo on the right lane, well, you're still gonna have enough elixir to go with the deadly Prince charge on the opposite lane. So yeah, you can always pressure your opponent on both lanes with this deck, and that's what I really love about this strategy. So let's do some battles and I'll show you guys what this deck is about. Up against Monzo here, good luck. We have the Hog Rider Skeleton's Cannon Zap, and our next card is the Fire Spirit. So we're gonna start off with the Hog Rider at the back just to generate some elixir. He's gonna go with some goblins. Okay, so we're gonna go with Fire Spirits and Skeletons, and our Fire Spirits are gonna take out his goblins. We can ready our Zap right here. Nice, got a bunch of his minions, and now we can just use the Baby Dragon here to take out all of these minions. Now they are level 11, so it's okay. Nice, we took them out. So here we're gonna go with the Hog Rider again, and this time add in the Fire Spirits. So let's see what he does. He's gonna go with the cannon. Our Fire Spirits are gonna take out that cannon very quickly, and there we go. We still have one Fire Spirit, did some good damage. Unfortunately, those goblins are level 11. If they were level 10, our Fire Spirit would have taken them out. Okay, but let's see here. Now we still have a lot of elixir, and the reason for that is because our average elixir cost is very low. He used the cannon previously, so he probably doesn't have it in his hand again. So we're gonna go with the strong Prince charge move right here. He's gonna go with some minions. We're gonna save the Zap and instead use the Baby Dragon here. Now the reason he couldn't defend there very well was because he placed down the pump, so he spent 5 elixir there. Here we're gonna go with the minions, and let's see, he does have a cannon, that's why I didn't want to go with the Hog Rider yet. But here he's gonna send out some minions, we'll zap them, and once we get rid of them, then we can go with the strong Hog Rider push with the Fire Spirit. So here the cannon's gone, and now we can send out the Hog Rider Fire Spirits. We have enough elixir to do so. He's gonna send out some goblins, he's gonna fireball as well. Okay, so he spent a lot of elixir to counter that combo, but we still did some good damage onto that tower. It's at 710 now, so that's great. But unfortunately, again, he most likely has his cannon cycled back to his hand right now. So we're gonna have to play a bit slower here. We can't just go straight up with the Prince charge because it's just gonna get blocked by his cannon. Here, we're gonna send out minion skeletons. We're gonna zap right here. Have to quickly take out that Royal Giant because it's very powerful. Level 11 as well. On the other side, we're gonna use the Fire Spirits. Oh, we didn't need to use the Fire Spirits because our Baby Dragon did splash damage. But there he sent out some goblins for some reason. Here he's gonna go with the Prince. We're gonna go with the sneaky Hog Rider push, and at the same time we're gonna zap right here. But unfortunately he countered that with his cannon, and that's a level 11 Royal Giant, of course, so it's gonna deal a lot of damage. But here, let's see, we're gonna go with another sneaky move because he may not have the cannon back to his hand. We're gonna use the Fire Spirits here. We're gonna send out the cannon and then zap that Royal Giant, have it reset its target onto our cannon, and now the time's up. So that was such a clutch move by us. We used the zap spell to have his Royal Giant retarget onto our cannon, preventing it from taking down our tower and us winning on time. That was crazy. Good game. So another version of this deck I really love to use is with the Princess. She's only 3 elixir, unlike the Baby Dragon, who is 4 elixir. And with her long range, really helps out with the Prince and Hog Rider, especially since the Prince is very easy to distract with those low HP hordes such as skeletons and goblins and stuff. So let's go for another battle here up against the Juggernaut. Good luck. Not a very good starting hand, lots of low elixir cards, but no Prince or Hog Rider to form a combo. So we're gonna have to go with some minions here, and then we're gonna send out the Princess, spread her so that she's not too close to the minions, so that he could have just used arrows on. But here he's gonna go with the fireball. We'll go with some skeletons, and on the other side I'm pretty confident that I can stop Sparky here. So here what I'm going to do is just use my fire spirits. They're going to distract. We'll use the zap to reset, but that was a bad idea because his goblin survived. But luckily I avoided the damage from Sparky on time, so that's great. We'll go with the Hog Rider Skeleton combo right here. He has a baby dragon though, and let's see, baby dragon's gonna take out our princess. We did get like three good shots onto that tower though, so that's not bad. That's not too bad. Still, we're behind here, so we're gonna need to pick it up. Our tower's at 1584, not good. He is a higher level with much higher level cards, so he does have the advantage there. We're gonna go with the minions and then send out the fire spirits. So let's see what he does to counter this push. He's gonna go with the Sparky. Not a very good idea, because what we're gonna do here is zap, reset Sparky, and allow our prince to get another shot onto that tower. So that was a great play on my part, if I should say. So we're gonna go with the princess here. At a distance, target Sparky. He's got Royal Giant. We're gonna need to use the skeletons to take out the Sparky. On the other side, we have the minions doing some damage. Come on, take out the Royal Giant. He's gonna take our tower, unfortunately. It was just too powerful. But here, we're gonna send out our Hog Rider. Let's see, can we get that tower? Yup, one shot and another shot, and that should do it. Nice. Okay, so we got back that tower. Now we need to focus on that other tower. Our tower is not looking very good. We're at 1356. We know he has a Royal Giant, so we're gonna have to place a cannon ahead of time to disallow that Royal Giant from like instantly targeting us. Here he's gonna send out Mini P.E.K.K.A. We can just use that. Send out the Hog Rider, add in the skeletons here. Now we have a very powerful combo, and we can zap and get some good damage onto that tower. Come on. Nice. It's at 818. Nice. Okay, here, let's place down that cannon. And there we go. There's a Royal Giant. That's why we needed to place that cannon ahead of time. Come on, take out the baby dragon. We have to take out the baby dragon. Oh my goodness. Okay, let's see. Add in the fire spirit. And there we go. Add in another princess. We have two princesses with the prince. We're gonna zap right here, and there we go. Can't get it. Oh my goodness, 158, guys. We have to take that tower because he has the Royal Giant. Can we push it back? I'm hoping I can push it back here. No, that's gonna be game. Oh my goodness, that tower on the top left at 158. I couldn't push back. I misplaced my cannon, otherwise I could have pushed back his Royal Giant there, and that's gonna be game. Okay, let's do one more up against Nando. Good luck. Hog Rider, Prince, Zap, and Cannon. Okay, let's go with Hog Rider and Fire Spirits, because we have Fire Spirits as our next card, so we'll start off with that combo. He's gonna go with the Cannon, okay, and Zap. Okay, so that's going to successfully stop us there, but let's see, once that Cannon degrades, we're gonna send out first the minions here, waiting for that cannon to pretty much wither away so that I can then send out my prince. So now I'm going to send out my prince on the other side, since he sent out his musketeer on the left side. The musketeer isn't a very big threat being unsupported. So here what we're going to do is just use the skeletons to counter the musketeer. And on the other side, as you guys can see, the princess with prince combo is dealing very good damage. And there we go, took out the collector with the princess's area damage, long range attack. And here we have the Hog Rider, we have some minions. Minions are gonna take out the Valk, nice. And he still has his musketeer though, so let's see. Musketeer is gonna take out our princess. So yeah, we are of course dealing with the higher level player with stronger cards, but no excuses. Let's go with a princess, and he has a cannon which we can just quickly take out, and then I'm going to ready my Hog Rider. But the problem is he already has his Valkyrie most likely, so can't counter that yet. What we can do is, let's see. Okay, there we go. Now he sends out Valkyrie. Bad idea, because now we're going to go with the Hog Rider push right here on the other side, use our cannon, pull in that Hog Rider. And there we go, dealing a lot of damage onto his tower. Unfortunately, his Valkyrie is level 9, Hog Rider is level 8, so they are going to get good damage onto us, even though we made a pretty good move there. But here, his cannon's gone. We're going to send out the Princess, Hog Rider, skeletons. He's gonna place a pump. He's most likely gonna place his Valkyrie soon. Nope, another cannon. Okay. He's gonna zap the princess. Not sure why, because that's not gonna kill her. Here he's gonna go with the Valkyrie now. Now we have minions with the prince. So, oh no, the poison took it out quick. So that must be a really high level poison to do so. Let's see, we're gonna go with the princess. We do know he has a Hog Rider push for us coming, but we're gonna go with the fire spirits. And for that musketeer, we'll just use the skeletons, and they're gonna take out the musketeer. And before he counters our princess with his Valkyrie, again, we're gonna go with the prince and the minions together. So he's gonna have a very hard time countering this, but he's gonna poison here. But he already used the poison on the other side. Nice. So here we can use the princess, took out his tower. Nice. And oh, time's up. That was clutch. Good game. Thanks. So I hope you guys enjoyed those battles and also liked the deck. Thanks for watching. Be sure to leave a like and also subscribe for more daily Clash Royale content. I'll see you guys again soon. Later. Life.